What is up, guys? Welcome back for our third and I think final installment of the Genesex Suspect Test. The reason I'm saying it's the final installment is because we are currently at 2,500 coil. We need 2,700 to get requirements to vote for the band. And I only have 10 games left to go. I went a little bit on tilt, I'm not gonna lie. There were two scenarios where I went on tilt. One was with this team, actually. And the other one was with a different team. It was actually a mix of a bunch of teams. But anyway, today we're using a team passed to me by my good friend Johnny or Risepool. If you don't know him, check him out in the description down below. I'm going to leave the link to his channel. He will be uploading for NPL Miners. I know there's nothing there right now. It's a very bare channel, but he's going to be uploading for that. I know that much. So yeah, this is a team that he passed us. It's been doing pretty well the last couple of games, but you really, really have to play it systematically, and there are a lot of loss conditions with this team, which I really don't like, especially the fact that it's got three priority users and paired with Tapu Lele, which sets up psychic terrain late game. So that's really it's counterproductive, in other words. But let's try to find a game. Let's see if we can. I'm gonna try to get all 10 games in this episode. If you see that it's very long, it's probably because we made it to the end of the 10 games. If it's not too long, then maybe it's just that we didn't make requirements and that's the end of the run. But anyway, we get Breaching Trout, game one. He's got a Darmanitan, a Blastoise, a Tangrowth, cool little fire, water, grass core. This looks like a league team. I'm not gonna lie, this looks like a league team, straight up. But yeah, no, I like the matchup. I like what Serp can do to him. Serperior can actually destroy him. I just need to get it in at the right moment, probably against Blastoise or even a weakened Nihilego. That'd be fine. I think I'm just going to lead off here with Mamoswine is fine because we are sashed. He's going to lead off with Blastoise though, so that's a great lead option on his end. He's probably Mega Blastoise, so I don't really want to stay in here. I have a decent switch in, and let's go into Superior. Let's see. He's going to Mega Evolve. He is going to go for the Water Pulse, so running Water Pulse. He confuses me, unfortunately, but I am just going to go for the Leaf Storm. Confusion is a lot less this gen, if you guys don't know. It's only 33%, so that's really, really nice. He is going to go into his Magearna. It reveals to be Leftovers as well. Not sure what this thing is going to be, but I don't really want to test the waters because my Superior is extremely important this game. I'm going to go out into Scizor on this 100%. As he goes for the Fluorocannon and misses, unfortunately, but that is a free U-turn for us, and he should also be faster in theory than us if he's running max speed. He might not be because of that of the leftovers, but either way, I think just U-turning is the correct play. He is going to stay in, and he is slower than us, which means he's min speed, absolutely min speed. I'm going to go out into Garchomp here, threaten this thing out with an Earthquake. As he goes for a Volt Switch, awesome. And I think I am just going to go for a Swords Dance here because I don't expect him to want to stay in. He has a Landorus. He has a Tangrowth. He should switch out here because Garchomp destroys this with an Earthquake, and this is literally his only switch into Superior. He does go into Nihilego, actually, as we go for the Swords Dance. He could be Ice Beam with Air Balloon. That is a very, very real thing. This team doesn't have any hazard removal though, but I am just going to go out into Scizor. I can't risk it. He is going to go for Hidden Power Ice. Oh yes, that's right. It doesn't get Ice Beam. Wow, bro, wake up. I got to go for another U-turn here. He is going to go out into his Lando. This is going to reveal what kind of Landorus set he is, which is nice. I think that is defensive if I'm not mistaken. I just want to calc that beforehand. Landorus, I'm just going to move this over for you guys. Hold on. So you can actually see what's going on. There we go. Gonna wait until this disappears. There. And now we're gonna go Mega Scizor. Bulky Swords Dance with a U-turn after the Intimidate. No, he's actually offensive. Okay, we're gonna go into Mamoswine then. That'll scare this thing out. And I'm going to... I really want to double into Superior, but I think he's just gonna go for the U-turn. I'm gonna go for Stealth Rocks. I really wanted to double into Serp, but it wasn't worth it. He's gonna go out into Blastoise. I think just switching back out into Superior is the play, because at this point, if he goes for a Rapid Spin, then I'm fine. He goes for the Water Pulse, gets the Confusion again. Wow, okay. I'm going for Leech Seed this time because, does this thing have Ice Beam? No, he has Rapid Spin, okay. So that's fine. We're gonna get a little bit of health back. We did break through the Confusion again. He spun away the leech seeds. Okay, that's a little bit annoying. I'm gonna go for seeds again, as he's gonna switch out into his Tangrowth, actually, and we're gonna hit ourselves this time, but it only did 6%, so we're fine. This is gonna be a long and draggy game, isn't it? I don't want to risk him having HP fire. Alright. I'm going out into Tapu Lele, because I don't mind getting knocked off. He's actually gonna pull a double into Darmanitan. This actually works out for us, because we're scarfed. And I don't think he knows that. I'm gonna go for Psychic. He's scarfed too. Good to know. Good to know. As he's gonna go out into Magearna. Okay, this is his response. It's gonna take 27%. Response, 27%. Gonna go out into Scizor here. I kinda wanna go into my ground types, but not really. Scizor is definitely the better play every time, as he does go for the Flash Cannon, revealing another move on his set, which is great. And now what I'm gonna do is I'm actually gonna Swords Dance, as he's probably just gonna go for the Volt Switch. No, he goes for Floor Cannon. Awesome, okay. And now we are going to go for the Bullet Punch as he switches in his Landorus. This is not gonna take this well at all. As you can see, it gets crit and it takes 66%. We're gonna go for another one. This will kill. By the way, that would have 2-hit KO'd regardless of the crit. Actually, it would have been kind of close, but it would have been, I think, in my favor. He is gonna switch out into his Darmanitan to take a Bullet Punch. That's not gonna take that well. And we are going to switch out directly into Garchomp, because if he clicks anything other than Flare Blitz, I think that's a bad play, because this thing is a huge threat to you right now. He does click Earthquake, okay. That's fine. He is locked into it. We know that. We know he's scarfed because Tapu Lele is scarfed. And I think I just click Dragon Claw here, honestly. Yeah, I think I just click Dragon Claw. He's going to go out into Lando. This should die, regardless, because we're Life Orb. Yep, it does go down. Beautiful. And I still have my Sash on Mamoswine, so that's great. He's gonna go out into Nihilego. I expect him to not click HP Ice this time, because I switched out into Scizor last time. So I'm actually just gonna go for the Dragon Claw on his Stealth Rocks. Beautiful, as predicted. And there goes the balloon. We are going to take a little bit of Life Orb damage, and the HP Ice is imminent. So in comes Scizor, as he goes for the Power Gem, actually. So great play. However, Bullet Punch knocks him out, so I don't expect him to stay in. I'm gonna go for a Roost, as he does stay in, and he just goes for Power Gem. Okay, that's fine. How much is his Magearna at? I think I left it a little bit lower, right? Huh. How do I win this? Okay. We need to go into Tapu Lele regardless, I think. And I think I need to catch the Magearna on the switch. So I'm actually going to double into Mamoswine. We're going to pull two doubles. I'm going to double into Mamoswine on his switch out into Magearna. And then I'm going to double into Serp on his switch out into Blastoise, because he shouldn't want to stay in, and he could go into Tangrowth, though. Hold on a second. If he goes into Tangrowth... Actually, I think I just Earthquake here. Yeah, he does go into Tangrowth. That's fine. Okay, now we are going to set up the Stealth Rocks, and if he switches out into Blastoise, I still have Superior as a switch in. I just have to be careful about his Darmanitan. He does go for Giga Drain. He is going to knock us out. I didn't expect him to actually knock us out there, but alright. I think Lele is my play, for sure. He's not going to want to stay in here. And I think I'm just going to go for HP Fire, because it hits both Magearna and Tangrowth. He's going to stay in, actually. I think he's AV. He goes for Sludge Bomb, knocks us out, okay. And are we going to lose the first game? That would be really sad. Okay, I'm going to go out into Garchomp. We're gonna click Fire Fang. I'm gonna try to win this with Greninja. See if I can do it. We're gonna get a good amount of damage off on his Tangrowth. His Giga Drain is gonna kill us though. Now I have to go out into Greninja, and I have to spam Dark Pulse and hope we flinch. He's gonna go out into Magearna though. Okay. All right, that's fine. We are gonna go for another Pulse. We need to try to flinch this thing down. That's our only play. If we can manage though, that would be great. He's got a really good team. He's got a super good team. He goes to the Volt Switch. That's not going to knock us out, actually. However, I am in range of rocks. He brings in his Darmanitan for some reason. He's just going to go for Flare Blitz, I guess. Yeah, there it is. Yeah, and that's going to win him the game. Because we're leftovers and he's scarfed. So, yep. That's going to be a first loss. However, that team was sick. That team was honestly sick. It was really good. But we should... Okay, this is more... normal. He still has a Tangrowth, which is extremely obnoxious to this team, but this is definitely a team we can handle. I expect Scarf Heatran because I went on tilt against Scarf Heatran a lot. Okay, I'm going to ignore this guy because he's already going off. And we are going to lead off here with Mamoswine because it has a great lead matchup against pretty much everything except for Tapu Fini. And a little bit of Tapu Lele, but it's fine. I can switch into Tapu Lele decently with Scizor. Unless it's carrying HP Fire, which I can't see on this team. Just because he does deal with Scizor relatively well with Heatran. So, I don't know. We'll see. I'm going to start the timer on this man. He's taking quite a while. He's busy talking. If I just do this, you guys will see. Empo, Mimanka, Poco. Oh, okay, he's probably almost at Rex. That's what he means by that. He's gonna lead off with Tapu Fini, so not the greatest lead for us. However, I am just going to switch out into Superior here, no reason not to, as he does go for the Surf. And now I'm gonna expect the switch out into his Heatran, and I'm gonna double back into Mamoswine, because if he Surfs again, that's actually a bad play. There is the Heatran, beautiful. It's not Air Balloon, that's fantastic. And we are just going to go straight for the Stealth Rocks. As he switches out into Lando, that is fine. We are going to click... I'm actually going to click Ice Shard right here. As he goes out into Tapu Fini, that's fine. If he goes for the Defog, he gives me the Evasion boost. So that's a really cool little combination there that those two have. I'm going to go for Leech Seed. I love the Tapu Fini. I can't touch Superior. He's going to go into Heatran. We are going to get off the Leech Seeds. Now, I'm not sure if I want to risk this thing being Scarfed, to be perfectly honest with you guys. We do have the Thick Fat on Mamoswine, so we should be able to take Lava Plume, or maybe not Fire Blast. I'm going to go on into Garchomp just to play it safe. I don't want to risk it versus this thing, as he's going to double out. Okay, so that pretty much tells me that he's not Choice Scarfed, because he didn't want to stay in. So I'm just going to once again play it safe and go for Earthquake, as he does go out into his Tangrowth, that's fine. And now we are going to switch out into Scizor, because this thing looks physically defensive, as he's actually going to pull a double out into his Tapu Fini, which is fine. I'm going to go for the U-turn. We should be faster, as we're not. He just goes for a Surf, that's fine. Going to go for the U-turn, going to go out into Serp, and this time I'm going to click Leaf Storm, because I don't want to take a Moon Blast, and he does still switch in his Heatran, though. Wow, okay. Are you Leftovers? You are Leftovers. Okay, good to know. Good to know. Let's go back into... No, let's actually... let's go for Leech Seed. Since he's... Okay, he just Magma Storms straight up. Alright, fair enough. Back into Mamoswine we go. Except but now we have nothing to take advantage of Defog. That's the problem. I'm going to go for Earthquake here. Because if he stays in, he dies. If he goes into Tapu Fini, it takes a lot of damage. So that's always good. And this thing not having any reliable recovery is very nice. I'm going to go out into Tapu Lele here because his switch-ins are very limited. As he does double out into Lando, actually. We are Scarfed, so and his Stealth Rocker should be his Heatran, in theory, because it's Leftovers. I'm going to go for the Psychic here. As he does switch out into Metagross, I was ready to go for the Shadow Ball there, but I just couldn't pull the trigger. We're going to go out into Scizor here. As he does go for the Pursuit, actually. Okay, that's fine. That means Scizor doesn't take any damage. And I'm just going to go for the U-turn again. I am faster than pretty much everything on his team with Tapu Lele, so that's nice. He is going to go out into Heatran. Back into Mamoswine we go. And I am going to click Stealth Rocks because his team is... Actually, his team's not too Stealth Rock weak now that I look at it. But I think Rocks is still the best play. As he's going to go out into Lando, that's fine. And I'm going to... that's not a good play. I think Icicle Crash, of course. Oh, come on, man. Of course he dodges. Is he going to risk another one, though? Okay, I'm going to be a man and click Earthquake. I'm going to expect the Tapu Fini to come in. As no, he just stays in again to Earthquake. Wow. Wow, wow, wow. All right, we're going into Greninja, and we are clicking... I'm clicking U-turn, because he just doesn't care. This man doesn't care about his Lando at all. His Earthquake did 40 to my Scizor. This is supposed to be bulky Scizor, so yeah, about that. He is going to knock me out with that one. I'm going to go back into Greninja. I have to click Hydro Pump now because he refuses to acknowledge that his Landorus is going to die and that he's going to give me a free Battle Bond. Now he's going to go out into Tapu Fini. I wonder how well you take this. Actually, no, I don't wonder. I'm going to go out into Tapu Lele, and he's going to click... he's going to click Defog anyway. Okay, that's fine. I'm going to go for the Shadow Ball here because I have to. His Metagross is still around. His Tapu Fini could also switch into Psychic, so can his Heatran. So I have no choice. I have to go for this because people don't value their Landoruses, man. And he switches in his Metagross on a Shadow Ball, of course, so that's going to be great. He's going to now go out into Heatran and take another Shadow Ball. Fantastic. We're going to get a Spidef drop. I'm not going to stay in here, though. I'm definitely going out into Garchomp, no matter what, as he goes for the Magma Storm. He gets a crit, of course. He gets rewarded for playing a little bit badly earlier. I'm going to go for Swords Dance, expecting to switch out into Tangrowth. And now we're going to go for a Fire Fang. And hopefully... Does this do more than Dragon Claw? This should be at 130. This should be at 120. Yeah, Fire Fang does do more. We're going for Fire Fang. And we are going to knock out the Tangrowth with a crit, a revenge crit. Beautiful. There's the Rocky Helmet, so that's what it was. In comes Tapu Lele, which I'm assuming now is Scarfed. And I'm going to go for the Earthquake. There is the Scarf. We are going out into our own Tapu Lele because I don't have a choice now. And I need to click Shadow Ball and hope that we win the speed tie. But of course we don't. And that is going to be GG. So that's another loss. Now if I can pull out 8 wins, maybe I can make the coil. Maybe. But I very much doubt it. If I win the next game, if I lose the next game, I'm stopping there, guys, because... Like, I really don't understand him staying in twice with his Landorus. Like, I went for Icicle Crash the first time, I predicted you, and then you stayed in again. I really don't get people this sometimes, man. It's just, it's frustrating. It's frustrating to say the least, because, maybe I'm just expecting too much. You know what? It's fine. Maybe people aren't that great. Let's lead off with Tapu Lele. Maybe I'm just overthinking things, you know? I didn't mean to say that people aren't great, but, like, maybe people don't think as far ahead as I do. Which is possible. I mean, you can be up here on the ladder and still not think as far ahead as your opponent. It's very possible. What's our rank right now, actually? Because that should be dictating my play. Suspect test, 1434. Where is that on the ladder? 1434 is pretty low, actually. Well, it's not super low. It's right here. 213. Okay, that's not the worst. We're gonna go for Moonblast. He's gonna switch out into a Scizor. Let it take damage. Fantastic. And I'm not staying in here. Actually, you know what? He can't hit me with a Steel move. I'm going for another Moonblast. It's fine. If he actually goes for a Roost right here... he goes for the U-turn. Okay, good. He's offensive as well. Otherwise, that would not have done that much. And he's gonna switch into his Kartana. Fantastic. This thing is scary. I'm gonna go out into Scizor here. Not staying in. He doesn't have any fire types. He doesn't have any, like, scary fairies. He's gonna go for the Leaf Blade there. That's not gonna do enough. And we are just going to click U-turn here. As he brings in Lando, because everybody brings in their Landorus on Scizor. It's the right play most of the time, unless you're bulky. Here's Mamoswine. Threatens this thing out immediately. And, you know what? I'm just gonna go for Icicle Crash. Because I don't have time to get up rocks. I'm getting off damage on something regardless, right? So, Psychic Terrain is only up for one more turn. That's a little bit unfortunate because I think that Scizor would have gone down to an Earthquake after an Icicle Crash. So he can technically switch in his Scizor here if he wants to. Which he does. And that's going to do a decent chunk. But I am just going to go for Stealth Rocks here. Because I expect him to Roost. As he does. Beautiful. And now my rocks are up. And his Hazard Removal is in against me right now. It is his Scizor. What's he gonna click? Let's go into Garchomp. He's gonna go for the Defog. I could have gone into Scizor, but it's fine. I'm gonna go for the Swords Dance now, because his Landorus is right there. And we are going to Swords Dance again on his rocks, because everybody gets up rocks right here. As he does, he goes for the HP Ice. Okay. Your Rocky Helmet. I'm going for Dragon Claw, and I'm knocking this thing out. Beautiful. Goodbye, Landorus. All right. So now it's looking more and more like Scizor can sweep. Again, I don't want to give this thing the Beast Boost. That would be just annoying. I'm going to go into Scizor directly. I'm going to keep Garchomp because it has one more use, which is actually... Do I stay in here? And just go for the Fire Fang? Yeah, let's just go for the Fire Fang. He might go for Swords Dance, expecting me to switch out into Scizor. He's gonna go for the Smart Strike. Good play. His speed does not go up. That is what I was worried about. We can now go into either Superior. Superior should be able to knock this out with a Hidden Power Fire. It's extremely powerful, and this thing has, like, no special defense whatsoever. Also going into Greninja and just fire off a Dark Pulse, too. I think that Tapu Lele is way too valuable because of his own Scizor. How much does Serp do in this match? It doesn't do too much, so I'm going to go into Serp, and we're going to click HP Fire. As he is Scarfed. Okay, so glad that didn't kill Superior the God, living a plus one Smart Strike from a Kartana. And in comes Tapu Koko, the threat. However, my opponent never got up rocks. And we still have a sash on Mamoswine, friends. And his entire team does not appreciate Mamoswine. Now, I expect this thing to either go for a U-turn or a Dazzling Gleam here. So I'm actually going to go out into Scizor first, as he does go for the Dazzling Gleam. And here's the electric move, so I'm going into Mamoswine 100%. If he clicks Dazzling again. Okay, good. He clicks Thunderbolt. Good. Good stuff. All right. Let's go for the Earthquake here as he switches out into a Scizor. Great. We're going to get off some damage on that. And then we are going to switch out into Tapu Lele here as my opponent decides to go for the Roost. We get up our Psychic terrain. And I'm going to go for HP Fire because, okay, he switches in his Mimikyu. That's fine. I don't have a problem with that. We will switch into our Scizor here. We broke the disguise, which is fantastic. And in comes Scizor. He misses Play Rough. That's kind of unfortunate, but it wouldn't have done much anyway. I'm just going to go for the U-turn here as my opponent decides to switch in his own Mega Scizor. And I'm going to... Yeah, I think Tapu Lele is always the play. He knows I have HP Fire now, though. So I have to be careful about this. I think he's going to predict it. I really want to say he's going to predict it. Yeah, I'm going to go for the Psychic. Nope. He stays into U-turn. So he would have taken a bunch of damage on his Scizor. But it's fine because our Psychic terrain is now gone. And that's actually good for me. Because I have Greninja. And Greninja just kills everything. So we're fine there. We also still have our sash on Mamoswine. Just keep that in mind. The Scizor no longer switches into two Earthquakes. In comes Mimikyu to do what, I'm not sure, but I am just going to switch out again into Scizor, and we're going to go for the, I'm going to go for the Swords Dance, actually. Yeah, I'm going to go for Swords Dance. He switches in his own Scizor, but his Scizor, I don't believe, beats mine, because he has Defog, and I have Roost, so yeah. I'm going to go for a Roost right here, as he goes for the U-turn. Except now I kill everything, so yeah, there's that. Noivern might come in. I don't know if Noivern takes this. Do you take a plus two Bullet Punch, Noivern? Let's see. Noivern, Choice Specs, Bullet Punch. Why does that do so little? Plus two. Only does 43 to 51, really? Tapu Koko comes in. I'm going directly into Mamoswine. Yep, there's the T-Bolt. And his Scizor, I think, is healed up. I can't remember now. But I'm just going to go for the EQ anyway. As he does go into Scizor, and it's not healed up. So that means I can EQ again. As he bullet punches, but that's not going to kill me. Goodbye, Sizz. And we're looking pretty good here. Because our Scizor is healed up. So if he wants to go into the Tapu Koko, he's going to take a Life Orb hit from hitting me. He's actually going to go out into Mimikyu, surprisingly. Well, maybe not surprisingly. But I am just going to go for the Earthquake right here. As he does go for the Shadow Claw, which is fine. Scizor pretty much walls this, and I'm going to go for a Bullet Punch here, and I'm going to knock out his Mimikyu, which is fantastic. And now all I need to do is make sure that Noivern doesn't kill me. So let's, Noivern's not faster than Battle Bond Greninja, though. So how do I play this out? I think I sack Serp to his Flamethrower, which I know is coming, as he goes for Hurricane, actually. Okay. If you don't confuse me with that, how much does Specs Hurricane do from Noivern? Does 72% max. So it's not enough to kill us. That's a little bit problematic, actually. Because if he is specs, I don't. How do I not kill him with two bullet punches? It's a Noivern. It has base 85 HP and base 80 defense. I am 307, right? No, I'm 336. I have more than this. How much did Johnny put in here? 336. I mean, I don't think it does enough anyway. It's only gonna do 24 to 28. Let's go for it anyway. Well, okay. Yeah, there's something wrong with the calc, because that should have done, like. Hold on. He's gonna go for another hurricane. I have to go for water shuriken here. And that's actually really annoying because I think I need 5 hits off on his Tapu Koko. I'll kill the Noivern. I'm not worried about the Noivern. It's Tapu Koko that I'm worried about. Ash Greninja, 252 choice specs. Where's choice specs? Choice specs. Where are you? Water Shuriken. Okay, that's with 3 hits. If I get 4, I actually kill it. Or if I get a crit on any one of them. Okay, let's go for Shuriken. Okay, maybe we're not gonna kill Noivern. Okay, whoo! We get the kill with the third hit. And now Tapu Koko comes in, and it all depends on whether or not we can hit this enough times. Let's go for the Water Shuriken. It's gonna do 30 on the first one, 28. And we get a crit on the last one. Oh my god. Wow, what a game, guys. What a game. You're seeing my reactions live now. Like, what? Yo, we actually crit one of them. It was, I think, a pretty good chance. It's a 12.5% chance to get, you know what I'm talking about. Anyway, we got Stall. Superior beats this other than Amoongus. So if I can kill Amoongus, I'm good to go. I'm gonna lead off with Tapu Lele because everybody leads with Sableye. It's crazy, man. Even if they see a Tapu Lele on the other side, they're still gonna lead with Sableye because free switch out into Chansey. But if I have Psyshock, you're dead. Like, anyway, I'm going off right now, but it's fine. He's gonna lead off with Sableye. He probably has Protect. So I'm just gonna go for the Moonblast. He is gonna Protect right here. And then he's gonna switch out into his Chansey. And I'm just gonna stay in. I'm not gonna stay in, excuse me. I'm just going to go out into Garchomp on his Chansey. There's no chance in hell he stays in here with his Sableye. Because if I'm crazy and I click Moonblast again, he just loses. He's gonna go out into Suicune, actually. I'm gonna go for Swords Dance. As he goes for a Scald, trying to get the burn. He doesn't get it, and we are going to go for an Earthquake here. And if I get off a lot of damage on this Suicune, we should be good to go. He does go into Skarmory. I can hit this, though, because I have Fire Fang. Yay! All right. I love you, Johnny. Thank you, Johnny. We're gonna go for the Fire Fang right here. If he goes for the Whirlwind, that's fine. If he sets up a layer of Spike, I don't care. It doesn't matter. Fire Fang is gonna 2-hit KO. We actually flinch him, too. That's actually pretty important. Because now I can go for another Swords Dance. And even with his leftovers, he doesn't gain back enough health. And should he switch in anything else here, he's going to die. He goes for the counter. He lets me get up another Swords Dance. That's amazing. Oh my god, crap. Yep. He's at 44. Unfortunately, he does go back up to full if he roosts, so I couldn't risk that. He goes into Tapu Fini. I don't think Tapu Fini takes this. It does not. It does not take a +2 earthquake, friends. And yeah, I think that's a clean sweep with Garchomp, guys. Yeah, I flinched him with Fire Fang. He was going for counter. He would have beat me. I'm gonna go for Earthquake again. It's easily gonna knock out Chansey. Everything's gonna die. Everything is just dead. That really sucks for my opponent. I'm gonna go for an Earthquake here. Yep. Why am I even saying it at this point? You guys know what's happening. Yeah, bad game. Bad game for sure. I mean, I didn't know he had counter. I thought it didn't matter that I had flinched him, but it actually did. And yeah, so we are going to find another game. I feel bad about that one. I feel bad about worse about that one than I do about critting the Water Shuriken. Because the Water Shuriken, like, I don't know, man. I don't know. I just didn't agree with the way he was playing. I like the way he was using his Scizor, but the fact that he stayed in with it against my Tapu Lele, when he knew I had Hidden Power Fire and he would have let his Scizor get super weak, that was a really, really bad play, in my opinion. Because then my Scizor comes in and starts setting up Swords Dances. And if he wants to start roosting, I get up another SD. And then he's forced to U-turn out. And then I kill Tapu Koko and Noivern. Why was the calc saying... I still want to figure this out here. Why was the calc saying that Tapu Koko took Scizor's... hold on. Scizor... not Tapu Koko, sorry. Bulky Swords Dance versus Noivern. I want to see why it says Noivern was taking this so well. Noivern, Choice Specs. Yeah, like, it wasn't giving me the right amount at all. I don't know if I was, like, not technician or something. If it, like, took off the ability. That's probably what happened. But anyway, we got a team with two Tapus on it. I was going to say two Kokos. Entei is a threat. I saw that immediately. Sorry for the weird noise there. I'm going to lead off with Tapu Lele. He's going to lead off with Greninja. I'm actually just going to click HP Fire because there's no other switch in to a Moonblast than his Scizor, and his Scizor is just going to die, essentially. I'm actually not going to stay in here because I fully expect him to switch out into his Tapu Fini. So I'm actually going to go out into... That's tough, actually. That's really tough. I think I just go for another HP Fire. He's going to let his Scizor go down, and that's awesome, because now we can just spam Psychic. We can spam Moonblast, not Psychic. Not just yet. Not Psychic, because he does have the Greninja, so... we are going to knock out the Scizor very early, which is amazing. In comes the threat that I cannot deal with. This thing's going to burn me, isn't it? I already know it's going to burn me. I just, like... It's 50%, but I swear it always happens. Sacred Fire. Where's the burn? Show me the burn. No burn. Wow. Okay, I'm going for Swords Dance on his switch to Lando. And we're going to go for Dragon Claw here. I'm going to get off a lot of damage on this Landorus. It is Rocky Helmet. He is probably going to get up rocks. No, he goes for Toxic. Okay. I'm going to actually go for... I'm just going to Dragon Claw again. I don't care. I don't care if my Garchomp goes down to this. It's fine. He just had to sack two Mons, essentially, just for one. So, and now that thing's dead. Huh. I think Mamoswine is always my play, right? As he goes out into Tapu Koko, that's fantastic. I'm just going to go for the Stealth Rocks. As you guys saw earlier, we do get the evasion boost from the Defog with Tapu Fini. He's going to go out into Greninja, actually. Okay, that's a curious play. I'm going to switch out into Scizor here as he goes for the U-turn. Good play. And he's going to go out into Entei, which now I don't have a switch into. Except for Greninja. Greninja can take it, right? No, not very well. We're going to go for the U-turn. He's not going to want to stay in on a water move. In comes Tapu Fini. Fantastic. Now we get up a sub with Serp. Or I could just go for the Leaf Storm, realistically. Yeah, let's just go for Leaf Storm. Honestly, who cares? If he goes for Defog, that's a bad play. Yep, gives me the evasion. I'm going to go for sub. Let's try to make him miss. He gets the Moonblast off. I'm going to go for Leech Seed, as he's going to go for a taunt. Okay, that's fine. We're going to go for another Leaf Storm now. And I still have the evasion boost. Like, I have plus 4 right now with evasion, as he goes out into Entei. I don't know how well you think you take a Leaf Storm, buddy. But you don't at all. You just die. Oh man, I love Superior. It's actually good. It's actually so good. GG. Yeah, because now I can spam Moonblast against him, essentially, is why he forfeited. He knew that my Tapu Lele was scarfed, because if it was Specs, it would have knocked out his Scizor, no questions asked. So, yeah. What just happened? I dropped something. I'm sorry, guys. Yeah, let's keep going. I mean, we're at 33 minutes, right? How many games am I at now? I'm going to check it out here in the lobby, /rank. And we have 65 games completed. I still have 2556 coils. So I think even if I win the last 5, I don't think I'm going to make it, guys, because I'm going to be like 49 and 21, which is really sad. I was really close this time, but you guys are going to get to see. I think I'm going to stop when we lose a game. If we win all 5 and we don't make requirements to vote, then I'm going to show you guys my rank, my record, and everything so you can get an idea of, if you ever want to participate in a suspect test, exactly what kind of level of play you have to be at. Because 49-21 doesn't seem that bad. It's not that terrible of a record when you can factor in the fact that you can get hacked, you can have terrible matchups. You can't win every game. It's impossible. You can't just go 70-0. So, I mean, people get lucky. People do end up making requirements with very, very good records. But typically, you're going to see, like, 55-15. Like, that'll be the cutoff for, like, pretty damn good players. So, all right. So, we got a Firewater Grasscore with Greninja, Heatran, and Venusaur. All things that this team hates, absolutely hates. I think I need to... That's tough. I'm going to lead off with Scizor. Actually, against his Greninja. That's what I was hoping to see. Let's go for the U-turn. He might do the same. Or he might go out into his Landorus. Either way, his switch into this right now is... Okay, he's actually just going to go for a Hydro Pump and let me knock out his Greninja, which is fantastic. That's amazing turn one. Because that means that I can spam... I can't spam Psychic yet. But one of his fastest Pokemon is gone, which is phenomenal. And his biggest threat to my Mamoswine, other than Venusaur. So, yeah. That's great that that's gone. I'm so happy he let me do that. In comes Venu, which we talked about just now. And I don't have a solid switch into this. I think getting up rocks is actually quite important against his team because of the Heatran, because of the Tapu Lele. At the same time, though, Scizor does outspeed Venusaur, doesn't it? Like, it's standard set. It does outspeed it, if I'm not mistaken. I don't want to switch in Tapu Lele on a Sludge Bomb. That's my only problem. I'm going to go for Stealth Rocks. He's probably just going to go for a Giga Drain. He's going to go for an HP Fire, predicting my Scizor, actually, which is fantastic. And the problem is now that his Giga Drain still does a ton. And I don't have a... I have a switch in. It's Scizor. He's going to go for Drain. He broke my sash. Yeah. Okay, cool. Let's go for the U-turn and expect the HP Fire. And we have to go out into Garchomp. That's my only play right now. As he is going to go for the HP Fire, revealing... well, he already revealed that. But I'm going to go for Swords Dance. He's going to go for a Synthesis, which is great. We're going to go for another SD. As he actually switches in his Landorus. So this should actually die, regardless of being defensive. It just goes straight down. Beautiful. We take Rocky Helmet. We take Life Orb. But his play now has to be into Tapu Lele because it is clearly scarfed. He's going to click Moonblast. I don't have a switch in, unfortunately, but Garchomp still puts in so much work, especially that we left, well, his Venusaur is not weakened, but it can't switch in well to Earthquakes, not Life Orb Earthquakes, not from this thing anyway. I think my play is actually just to sack Superior. It does nothing else this game, and he's going to go for Psychic, actually. Which is great because I get to switch out into Greninja. As he goes in into Venusaur, I'm not too concerned. I'm just going to go for the U-turn, get some momentum, and I'm going to go out into Scizor again. And he's going to go for the Giga Drain once again. I can see him going for another Giga Drain knowing that I'm faster than him. Actually, I'm going to U-turn into Superior this time. And he's probably going to go for Synth. Okay, yeah, I probably should have predicted that. What? Hands free, leave it alone. We're going for the switch into Tapu Lele. Yeah, I'm switching out into Tapu Lele on his HP Fire. I'm threatening this thing out purely because I want to get a free switch out into my Garchomp. Psychic terrain is down, but he's still going to take a ton from Psychic, and he doesn't know what set I am. Are you kidding me? What if I sludged? You weren't going to sludge while I have a Scizor that I can keep pivoting into, bro. And now I'm going to go Earthquake here, and Earthquake is going to do a lot to something. If I'm able to knock out his Heatran, that's great. He's actually not going to let it go down. He's going to let his Tapu Lele drop, which is great. That's going to go straight down. That was a huge threat to me, and he's just going to forfeit. Okay, yeah, sure. He was really angry about that. He was like, what if I sludged? I'm like, you haven't revealed sludge, that's one. And two, I'm weaker to HP Fire than I am to Sludge Bomb. There was no way he was clicking Sludge Bomb there and allowing my Superior to come back in. I actually played this guy earlier, I think. No, I didn't. But I played a very similar variant of the team. It didn't have Zapdos. So I think I might have played this guy and he realized how much a Superior was a huge threat to him. So I think he replaced something with Zapdos. I think it was a Mandibuzz. Yeah, I'm pretty sure it was a Mandibuzz. Okay. Alright, I see you. But now you're weaker to Mamoswine, so I really don't care. Let's lead off with Lele. We're going to do the same thing we did before. He's going to lead off with Sableye. He's probably going to click Protect, as he does. And now we're going to go out into Garchomp, because that's the best play. On his Chansey. He might predict Rocks, so we'll go for the Earthquake straight away. He's actually going to go out into Shedinja. That's fine. I'm going to click Fire Fang, as he actually switches back out into Mega Sableye. And we are going straight for the Earthquake. I'm not even thinking about it. We're getting off a ton of damage on this thing. He's going to go for the Will-O-Wisp. That's fine. I'm going to go for the Swords Dance. And I need to keep this thing as low as possible. He's going to go for the Recover. I'm going to go for another SD. He's going to go for Protect. That's fine. And now we're going to go for the Dragon Claw, expecting him to want to switch out into his Zapdos on my Earthquake. And in comes Zapdos. Beautiful. That's going to take a ton of damage from this Dragon Claw. It's going to take 59% to be exact. And I'm just going to go for another Declaw. There's no reason to predict a switch out here. If he lets his Zapdos go down, then he's just as weak again to Serperior. He's actually going to go out into Shedinja, which is fine. I can just Fire Fang here again. He's going to go for Protect. That's cool too. Fire Fang again is always the play. I'm not predicting anything. I could go for Earthquake here, but I'm not going to. He's going to go into Toxapex. This thing would have dropped. And I'm going to go for another Fire Fang as he switches back into his Zapdos. Fantastic. So this is going to take a ton. And now with his Zapdos solo, I'm just going to click Fire Fang again because it hits the Shedinja and it kills his Zapdos. So now with the Zapdos gone, right, guys, Serperior wins. there's no question anymore. However, it's going to be a lot harder for me to kill Sableye now. I'm going to be perfectly honest with you. We're going to go out into Tapu Lele as he goes into Sableye. He's going to click Protect anyway, so I'm going to go into Serperior here as he goes for the switch out, actually, into Shedinja. I'm going to go for the HP Fire. He's going to go for Protect. That's fine. I'm going to go for HP Fire again, because if he lets me get up a sub, that's a really bad play. No, let's go for sub. All right, in comes the Chansey. We are behind a sub. I'm going to go for Leech Seed, and now he's seated, and now this thing cannot beat me 1v1. We're going to go for sub again. And this is my other setup sweeper, and this thing just beats him straight up, guys. I never even have to click Leaf Storm against him. I just have to, like, the only thing I have to click Leaf Storm against is his Mega Sableye. He has to play so well around this. Like, he actually has to avoid me ever going for HP Fire as he switches out into Shedinja, because if I break that sash, it's over. So, yeah. This is looking pretty good. He's going to switch out into Toxapex, allow me to get up another sub. I'm going to go for a Leaf Storm. Okay, he makes a... Okay, he went into Sableye, actually, as I missed my Leaf Storm, unfortunately. I'm going to click HP Fire here, as he's actually just going to stay in. He's going to go for the knockoff, which is fine. I'm going to go for another for a Leaf Storm here again. If he switches into Shedinja, that is fine. He is going to let me hit him with a Leaf Storm as he goes for knockoff. However, 15%... Hidden Power Fire does kill now. He's going to go for Protect. That's fine. I'm going to click Hidden Power Fire again. If he wants to switch out into his Chansey, it's fine. He can't switch in his Dugtrio. Like, this actually just beats him, guys. I don't know if you've realized it yet. But the fact that he left his Sableye so low, I can get up Rocks later. He let his... this can go for Reversal, can it? Why did I have to crit him? Let's go for HP Fire. He is going to Reversal. It's not going to kill, though. It's not going to kill, guys. We're fine. He's going to go out into Chansey, clearly, because I can't kill that, and I can't Leech Seed on it anymore. No, he's going to go out into Shedinja to Shadow Sneak me. Okay, well, I'm going to switch out into Tapu Lele. That's the best play, 100% of the time. And he's not going to let me hit him, I don't think. Let's go out into... It's risky, but I think Mamoswine is my play. Greninja is not a terrible play. Serperior is a pretty bad play. no, Serperior is not terrible, actually. Serperior is fine. He's going to go for Protect. He can't go for Shadow Sneak anymore. I'm going to go for HP Fire. He doesn't realize that we're still in Psychic terrain, clearly. And he's probably going to switch out his Shedinja now. So I'm going to go for Leech Seed, as he actually goes for Protect. I'm going to go for Leech Seed again, because I don't expect him to stay in. If he stays in, then so be it, but he... can't hit me with what I assume is his only offensive move. As he is going to switch out into Sableye, that is fine. I can just go for the Leaf Storm on this. If ever... Okay, he's going to protect. He's going to try to stall out my Leaf Storms, I guess. It doesn't matter. I'm not clicking Leech Seed here because I can't risk this thing recovering up. He allows me to kill his Sableye, which means now I get up rocks no matter what. I am just going to go for a switch out into Scizor here. I'm not going to let my my Superior go down just yet. He's going to go for Seismic Toss. That's fine. I'm going to U-turn out. If he goes into Toxapex, I get up rocks and I kill his Shedinja. And that's pretty much my win con. He goes out into Toxapex. Beautiful. We're going into Mamoswine. I'm going for Stealth Rocks. If he scalds me, it's okay. It doesn't kill. And he needs to burn me to avoid me getting off a lot of damage on him. This is one of my last physical attackers left. However, if I damage this Toxapex, it's pretty much game over. He's going to go out into Shedinja. I don't really mind this at all because I can just go out into Tapu Lele now on his Shadow Sneak. And he goes for Will-O-Wisp actually, which is still fine because this thing is dead. I'm just going for a Shadow Ball here and I'm knocking this thing out. So goodbye, Shedinja. And Chansey can't really do anything. So yeah, he's going to forfeit. So that's the end of that one. We are at 45 minutes. I know this is painful to watch for you guys, because I'm probably not going to make it anyway. Let's check now. Where are we? Slash rank. Was that the game? No, we have three more to go. We're 2597, man. We're 103 off. 103 off from being able to vote for the suspect test. I'm going to shed a tear, honestly. I took off the label from this water bottle because I didn't want, like, copyright issues. Because I remember... what was it? Was it Shady? I think Shady was like trying to hide his, like the brand of water that he drinks. It's really funny. I was just like, I probably shouldn't keep this in the video now that I'm using face cam. So yeah. Okay, this team looks annoying. Actually, it's just a bunch of rock and ground types, isn't it? It's just a bunch of, the same typings, I feel like. It's actually not. He's the only like repetitive typing he has is steel and rock. But yeah, he has a bunch of steel and rock types. Anyway, my man does not appreciate Mamoswine at all. I need to get rid of Celesteela, though. Celesteela has to go. I'm going to lead with Garchomp in this game, as my opponent is going to lead with Celesteela. That is fantastic. We are going for the Swords Dance, my friends, as he is going to set up a Leech Seed, which is fine. I'm going to go for another SD, as he's probably going to protect. No, he chooses to stay in and go for a Heavy Slam. That is not going to do nearly enough. And now we are going to click Fire Fang. And he probably assumes that we don't have Fire Fang. So, yeah, this is going to do a lot. He's going to go for Protect. Okay, he's not going to want to take a Fire Fang now. So now I'm going to go for a Dragon Claw and whatever is going to switch in, which is going to be his T-Tar, which should die. In theory, and it does, beautiful. So we're gonna take just a little bit of damage. He's gonna bring in his Aerodactyl, which obviously revenge kills me because it's faster. However, Scizor is a pretty good switch to this thing. I don't mind it too much, as he does just go for the Earthquake. That is not gonna do too terribly much. We are going to go for the Roost right here because we are gonna gain bulk as a result of Mega Evolving. Stone Edge should not kill me. As he's just gonna go out into Toxapex, which is a great play every time. We're just gonna U-turn out. I'm getting like a little bit wonky now because it's really, really late. As I guess you could say it's really early, actually. The sun might start to come up back there if you guys... can you even see there? Yeah, you can. Let's just go out into Tapu Lele, honestly. Does he have Toxic Spikes? Let's find out. He does have Toxic. He does not have Toxic Spikes. Okay. How do I want to approach this? Well, I want to approach this by switching out into Greninja. He's just going to go into Toxapex every time, isn't he? It doesn't matter. Actually, no. Greninja is my play because he's going to go out into Celesteela. What? He went into Excadrill? Yeah, but his sand's no longer up. It doesn't matter. I'm going to go for Dark Pulse because it hits the Toxapex harder. As that does a massive amount of damage. Wow, Specs Greninja. Holy hell. Get a... Oh. I don't even want to compare that to... No, no, we're not doing it. All right, in comes Celesteela. I want damage off on this. I'm going for the Dark Pulse. Look at that crit. Look at that crit damage. He's going to go for Leech Seed. He's probably just going to go for Protect, not wanting to get crit again. We're going to switch out here into... I'm going to go into Superior, actually, because we can... We can play this Leech Seed game as long as this man wants. He's going to go for Leech Seed again, but I am a Superior. You cannot Leech Seed me. I'm gonna go for a Leech Seed on you. He's got Fire Blast. That's not gonna do nearly enough. He is gonna get the burn, however, which is a little bit annoying, but at the end of the day, it doesn't matter. I'm gonna go for Leech Seed again, expecting his, not this to come out, but I guess it does. We are gonna land the Leech Seed. That's fantastic. We're gonna get a lot of recovery from that. I'm gonna go for Sub now, as he is going to go for the Stealth Rocks, actually, which nerfs my, it doesn't nerf Garchomp, but it nerfs my Sash, which is a little bit annoying. I'm gonna go for Leaf Storm here, as my opponent's gonna switch out into Celebi, which is fine. Celebi shouldn't be faster than me. I'm just gonna fire off an HP Fire, get off some damage on this as well, as he's gonna go for a Psychic, which is also okay. We're gonna go for another HP Fire, because I expect him to stay in, not wanting me to get up another sub. If he does switch out into, okay, that's fine. That's great, because now he has no water switch-ins. He is forced to click a flying move that makes contact, so I'm going into Garchomp as a result. As he does go for the Ice Fang, actually. Good play. Awesome. Okay. I'm going to now switch out into Scizor, because this thing does not take me out. We're going to go for the U-turn. U-turn should be able to put him in range of Ice Shard, was what I was getting at. But he's actually going to choose to go into Celesteela, so now something just dies to Hydro Pump. Granting, I can connect it, of course. Something should be dead. He goes for Protect. That doesn't matter. He will still drop if I could connect, but I can't. He goes for Leech Seed. I am forced to switch out now. That is really annoying. And we have to go into... Actually, no, I'm just going to Hydro now. Yeah, weaken this thing. That's fine. He's going to go for the Heavy Slam. That's not going to do enough. He's going to go for Protect right here. I don't care, actually, if he gains back enough health, because he still technically doesn't gain back enough. I'm just going to go for another pump here. He has to hit a double Protect or bank on a miss. Either way, something's dead. His play might be to switch out, let something die, come back in with Celesteela and Protect, which is exactly what I think he's going to do. However, I'm not going to stay in with Greninja and let him get that free... Oh, wait, what? Why did he go into Aerodactyl? Huh? Wait a minute. What? I don't understand that play. Guys, I'm flabbergasted. I'm going for the Hydro Pump. He's got Pursuit. There was no way I was switching out there. That didn't make any sense. Scizor is always my play. He can't touch Scizor, from what I can see. He's got Earthquake, Ice Fang, Pursuit. I'm going for the U-turn here. He's obviously going to go back into Celesteela. However, now I can go into... Mamoswine, maybe? Maybe. This thing seems to be more specially defensive than it is physically defensive, so I really want to go into Mamoswine. However, I think going into Serp is actually a better play, because he's not... I don't think he's going to risk me getting up a sub. I'm just going to go for HP Fire. I think he's just going to Fire Blast, honestly. Like, realistically, that should be his play. He is not going to go for Leech Seed, that much I know. He's going to go for Heavy Slam. I'm just going to now go for another HP Fire. He's probably going to Protect. HP Fire still does 16%, though. I wonder how much Leaf Storm does, then. I'm going to go for Leaf Storm, just in case. He stays in. He lets me go for a Leaf Storm. He's going to go for another Heavy Slam. That's fine. Gets the Spadef boost, which is a little bit annoying, but I now have to go into Mamoswine, basically. I have to click Icicle Crash, no matter what. He's probably just going to Protect. There's a Protect. I could have gotten up Rocks, but it's not worth it at this point. Not with just an Aerodactyl left. I have to either flinch this thing or hope Icicle Crash kills. It won't, though. There's no way it does. Actually, this isn't Skarmory. Okay, it still doesn't kill. He misses the Leech Seed, though. Ooh, that sucks. Crash is still doing too much, though. 38%, meaning that Shard can't kill. He should go for a Protect right here, but he doesn't. He chooses to just let his... Okay, I'm going to go for the Ice Shard. Now, I cannot go into Tapu Lele under any condition. He goes for Stone Edge and misses anyway, so that's going to be our game. But yeah, I don't understand him going for Leech Seed there, because even after Protect, I don't think he gained back enough to be able to be mitigating the damage from Hidden Power Fire from Tapu Lele after, even with his plus 2 Spadef, because it is a Tapu Lele. It's very powerful, and that's a super effective hit. And then even if his Aerodactyl comes in after and kills me, he still has nothing to hit Scizor with, and I roost up on him until the psychic terrain goes away, and then I just bullet punch him twice and win. So I didn't understand him leech seeding there. He should have definitely just attacked. He would have been in a much better spot, but anyway. Now we have 68 games played. We are 26-24. I'm gonna get so close, aren't I? This guy's got a Bronzong, which is a very, very good bring, actually. But where are your Dark Pulse switch-ins, my friend? Where, oh, where, oh, where? I'm definitely gonna lead off here with Mamoswine, because I want to get up rocks early, because his hazard removal doesn't exist, and Pheromosa can't kill me because we are choiced, of course. Not choice, we're Focus Sash. I'm gonna go for Stealth Rocks. He's gonna go for U-turn anyway, it doesn't matter. He's probably gonna go out into Bronzong now. Yep, there it is. And he gets up hazards as well. However, his Dark Pulse switch-ins do not exist. Like I said before, they don't. They just don't. Bronzong is almost gonna die. As he goes for Trick Room. Explosion, right? Let's go into Scizor. I'm not taking an explosion. No freaking way. He does go for explosion. Yep. Beautiful. Alright. I can still Bullet Punch right now. That's the good news. Also, I'm faster than Tapu Lele in Trick Room. I should be faster than Diggersby in Trick Room as well. Let's go for the U-turn. As, no, he was faster than me. Okay, why did I Mega Evolve? Hold on. I shouldn't have done that. Okay, he's very, very slow, though. I can still go for priority, however. Is this thing banded? I guess it is, huh? Yeah, I can still go for priority. Who's his other Trick Roomers? I guess Cresselia? Tapu Lele blocks priority. That's huge for him. Okay, I think I have to go into Serp, knowing that this thing is probably banded. I'm gonna go for a Leaf Storm, because either way, I get off a hit on something. He's gonna go out into his Mimikyu. Okay, that's fine. Trick Room is still up for one more turn. He's red card. I don't want to lose Mamoswine necessarily just yet. Then again, no, it's fine. I can Earthquake. It's fine if he takes me out. He's gonna go for Destiny Bond. I'm not gonna kill you, are you? Am I? No, I'm not. Clearly not. I'm going to click... Does he really want to get rid of this that badly? I don't get that. Alright, if you want to get rid of it that badly, I'm gonna go for Ice Shard. It does kill. He does bring me down with him, but I didn't understand that at all. It's okay. I'm gonna go out into Greninja, because Greninja pretty much covers everything. I can go for a Water Shuriken on the Pheromosa and knock it out. Yes, that will... Okay, whoa, he's bulkier than I expected. Okay, that sucks. Because now I don't think I can deal with Cress. Wow. Why did that do so little? Greninja, why are you so weak, man? In comes Tapu Lele, actually. Okay. You're not Scarfed, because you're running a Trick Room team. So, I'm definitely faster with my own Tapu Lele. I can go for a Shadow Ball, but he still has a normal type. I have to keep that in mind. Yeah, this is a really annoying team, isn't it? Either way, I think Garchomp is the play. Yeah, let's go to Garchomp. We're going to click Earthquake. If he wants to go into Cress, that's fine. He is just going to stay... Of course, he lives on one. Oh, my God. All right. I have to go into my own Lele. And I think the best play here... I think the best play is to go for Hidden Power Fire, perhaps? No, what am I saying? Psychic is always the best play. Because I knock out his Tapu Lele. I think he's going to try to win with Diggersby. Either way, but... I knock out his Tapu Lele. If he goes into Cresselia and tries to... Okay, he goes into Pheromosa, though. Is he Scarfed, too? I mean, he doesn't kill... And now he's in range of two Stealth Rock switch-ins. He's Scarfed. Wow, he's Scarfed Pheromosa. Alright, I'm gonna click Superior, because he's gonna click Trick Room. No matter what, he's clicking Trick Room. No, he clicks Lunar Dance, and he heals up his... Okay. Great play. I'll give him that. We are going to go for a substitute on the off chance we can live a U-turn. That's hilarious. Yeah, Scarf Pheromosa coming through on a Trick Room team. Crazy. I know. In comes Diggersby. We go into Tapu Lele. We get a kill with Psychic, but he kills us anyway with Pheromosa, so it doesn't matter. There was nothing I could do about him being Scarfed. I really didn't expect him to be Scarfed, and I really expected Water Shuriken to kill. But anyway, That is going to be a 1-0 in my opponent's favor. That really sucks. And I don't know our coil now, but this is going to be our last game of the live, guys. We are approaching an hour. And we get a really funny team. Okay. I love seeing Alolan Exeggutor, honestly. I know this guy. I've played him before. Quite a few times, actually. All right. So I'm going to lead off with Tapu Lele. As he leads off with this thing. I'm going for Shadow Ball, predicting the Jirachi. Gonna get off some damage on this. It's gonna do 32, so he's obviously specially defensive, which is fine. I'm gonna go for another Shadow Ball. He's probably gonna go for Wish anyway. No, he goes for U-turn. Awesome. Okay, so we leave his Jirachi super low. He's gonna go out into Faramosa, which I don't know if that takes a Shadow Ball too well. But I don't want to take a U-turn either, so I'm gonna go out into Scizor, which is perfectly fine. He's gonna U-turn. He's probably gonna go out into Zard. It's probably Zard X as well. But as long as I have my Sash intact, I'm fine. I'm actually just going to go for a U-turn here, as he's going to, okay, Mega Evolve into Zard Y. I probably should have seen that coming with the Exeggutor in the back. I think that thing still gets Chlorophyll, right? All right, either way, we're going into Garchomp now. And I'm clicking Swords Dance, expecting him not to want to stay in on this, because I could very well be Stone Edge. So I fully expect the Tapu Fini to come in. It's his best switch. Like, if he actually stays in, that's like really bad. Because if I kill this, then he's in a bad spot. Because my team actually destroys his team. Okay, he stays in. He's got Solar Beam. Okay. Like, obviously, like, I'm not surprised by Solar Beam, guys. I just, like, expected Dragon Pulse. I don't know why. I'm going to go for Declaw here. If he actually pulls the switch out into Tapu Fini now, that's really good. But I don't think he would on a potential Stone Edge. That's the thing. Let's see what he does. If we knock out this Zard, we're in a great position. I lost my switch into Faramosa, kind of. Why does he wah? What? Bring the weirdness back. What? He's going to go out into his Rhyperior, actually, and let that die. So that's great. I don't have to deal with that anymore. Earthquake is always the play. Just kill this off. Beautiful. And now Faramosa comes in to kill me. not staying in. I'm actually going to go out into Tapu Lele here. Because I expect him to go for the Ice Beam and not the U-turn. But he goes for the U-turn. Okay. That's fine. I expect his Jirachi to come in. As it does. Beautiful. We'll go for the Shadow Ball again here. That's fine. And keep this thing low. As he goes for another U-turn. Knocks me out with a crit. That didn't matter. I don't believe anyway. I left everything pretty low though. Well, this specifically, but, like, his Rhyperior is gone. This is looking okay, because I still have the Sash. Don't forget, guys, I still have the Sash. He's gonna go into, Faramosa. I am going to force this thing to... Well, I don't really have a choice, because my Psychic Terrain is up, but I'm gonna force this thing to take some damage with his U-turn. And we are going to go for Earthquake, just in case, for whatever reason, he wants to switch out into his Tapu Fini directly. I know I'm getting further from the camera. Sorry about that. In comes his Zard, which of course is the biggest threat. Plungeware. Sorry, I'm reading people's comments. But I need to keep Mamoswine's Sash intact for the Faramosa, specifically. The problem is my Psychic Terrain is still up. Oh wait, however, I have a Superior. And Superior goes for Sub. And stalls out some Sun, which is a good idea. Let's do that. Let's go for another Sub here. And I'm stalling out my own Psychic Terrain as well. I don't know if you guys noticed, but that was the point of that. And now we are going to go directly into Greninja, I believe, because I still need Superior. And now we can... Okay, he's going to actually switch out into his this thing. But it's Frisk and Harvest. It doesn't have Chlorophyll. Why are you running this? I'm going to go for a U-turn. He's actually going to switch out into his Tapu Fini, which is great for me because now I can go out into Superior. And I can just go for a Leech Seed here. As he switches out into... Okay, he goes directly into this thing again. Not sure what this thing is going to click. I'm going to go for Sub. I don't know what it's going to do. He goes for Trick Room. Okay. Makes him fast. This thing gets Trick Room? Really? That's really good to know. I might try it out at some point. Let's go for the substitute again because he hits me first. Okay, he's got flamethrower. That's fine. We're going to go for another sub. And now we are going to go for... I think I just go for HP fire. It's fine. We're going to lose this game, by the way, guys. I don't know if you've noticed, but this game is done already. I'm going into Mamo because the sun is not up, and this is a technically a neutral hit. And we have Ice Shard on deck. So I want to say he's not going to switch in. Like, he's not going to stay in. So I'm actually going to go for Stealth Rocks right here. He's just going to click Giga Drain even though I have Ice Shard. Okay. As the Trick Room ends, I'm going to go out into Greninja and I guess lose because there's nothing I can do. I'm just going to go for the Dark Pulse as he stays in again. Doesn't get flinched. He gets Citrus, goes for Trick Room, has Giga Drain on deck and Flamethrower, so that's going to be GG. Nothing I can do about that. This thing is really cool with Trick Room, actually. It's really offensive and it's good with Citrus Berry. I like that. But anyway, guys, that's going to be the end of this run. Unfortunately, and yeah, I hope you didn't enjoy these episodes. If you did, make sure to leave a like down below. Let me know what you thought. If you want to see more Suspect Us like this in the future, I don't know how many people actually make requirements. Like, if I just check the ladder real quick, we can type, we can go Control F 27, and 67 people. So 67 people made requirements, and there are some people among those 2700s that you see up here that didn't actually meet the 70 game requirement. So let's say about 50 people. That means that 50 people on this ladder right now get the chance to vote on whether or not Genesect gets banned. So I think they should really drop it down a little bit, especially because, like, a lot of things can happen in Pokemon. That's just my personal opinion. If 2700 Coil works with them, like, some people made 3,000. That's insane. But if 2700 Coil works with them, then it's what we gotta use. So that's it, guys. Again, if you did enjoy, again, make sure to leave a like down below. Subscribe if you haven't already, and I will catch you guys later. Ciao.